I'm worried about Hugh. I know he could take care of himself, but I'm worried about him.
Well, from what Cedric said, he's survived this long. He's not stupid.
No, he's not.
One thing about that guy I've noticed, he's very observant, and I can only imagine that only helps him.
He'll be okay. We have to keep hoping, and we have to do our part. He'll do his, and we'll do what we need to do.
How's Halisair doing?
She needs to get whatever that is out of her, and fast. Which reminds me, I'm supposed to meet everyone by the mirror, like now.
You should go then.
Thank you for hanging that up. It was good.
Just trying to help.
You're doing good. And I gave Lealdin your notes, by the way. He didn't want the hug, but that's okay. I understand.
That's fine. I'm sure I'll see him soon enough.
He's a very cool guy. Hard to read.
I look to... Yeah, he is. I look up to him. And, I'm glad that you got to meet him. He's a great guy. He's one of my heroes.
You're not the only one. He's impressive.
Just like you are, Kenna.
Oh, Connor. Alright, I gotta go. And I'll give him a kiss on the cheek, and I'll leave.
He'll return the kiss on the cheek as well.
Okay.
You leave, and who is actually looking for Violetta, specifically?
That'd be me.
Okay.
I'll go with her.
Okay.
Yeah. I suspect we might also be bringing cardboard Theoben with us, but I don't know for a fact.
If you want to bring cardboard Theoben, that's fine.
Thank you.
You will find Violetta and Razakael in the library, and it looks like Violetta and Razakael are continuing on with their lessons, their language lessons. And Razakael will look up and give you guys an excited reaction when you return back. And Violetta will look up and say, "You all have returned." And she stands up. "Well, did you get it?"
"We got it."
"Oh, thank the Maker." "And Lealdin is?"
"Loaning it. We will need to reopen negotiations. But for now, at least, we have it. So I believe at the very least, we can take care of each other."
"Wonderful. All right, well, I need to gather up whatever things I need at once."
"Things have become urgent."
"How so?"
"I've lost control of myself. And I have tried to..." "Whatever is in this necklace, demon, spirit, whatever, it has taken over me. Within the past day, I lose control of myself, and I have tried to kill my friends, so this is now very urgent."
"Yeah, time crunch."
"Now that you mentioned that, that would make sense. If this curse is supposed to kill you, but it's also changing you, Alisair, I think someone's trying to replace you. I think that is what's the root of this curse. The question is who, but I believe the eye will be able to answer that question for us, and in doing so, hopefully, give me the insight on how to get rid of it."
"Then let's go."
All right. You will escort Violetta. You said that you were going to take her back to her wagon.
Yes. If she feels that that is where she needs to be to have all of her things.
That would be easiest.
Then let's do it there.
You are welcome to bring another NPC if you would like to bring another NPC with you.
Could we bring Owlet so he can hang out with Tangerine?
Yeah.
I would love to bring Owlet.
Sure.
I'm also wondering if we should bring, at the very least, Cedric and Andrea as well.
Oh, yeah, are all
I'm
of
going,
you not...
Unless everyone's coming with.
Yeah, I'm assuming everybody's going to be present for that.
Yeah.
Excellent. I didn't want to assume, but yay.
No.
Much better when we're all together.
This has been a day, right? So I can have my mana back.
Going down the mountain was definitely not a day. Going down the mountain was a few days.
It was a few days. So are we like at full now?
You're at full. Yes. It's been a few days. Quite a few days going down that mountain. So.
Sure. Oof.
Violetta will escort you into the room where she keeps all of her things, and she will take out a piece of chalk and start drawing a circle in the center. The circle, and when she connects the dots, it almost looks like the petals of a lotus. It's not perfectly symmetrical, it's like a petal of a lotus, petals of a lotus around. And then she takes out some candles and she places the candles around the circle. All right, she says, this is merely a binding spell to make sure that if you indeed have a demon within that necklace, it will keep the demon inside the circle, at least during the duration of the eyes trying to do its thing. This is mostly for not only our protection, but for yours as well, Hali.
Should we prepare for battle? I mean...
I am not going to tell you not to, but, as I said, this circle should keep any threats contained. I cannot promise that it will help us expunge or eject the creature, but at least will give us enough to learn what this is all about and get to the bottom of this.
All right. I'll get ready.
If you would, Hali, into the circle, please.
She steps unhesitatingly.
You go into the circle, and Violetta will take out a match and start lighting all of the candles until they're lit. The lotus petals have seven petals, so there's seven candles around the circle. She then will take out her voodoo doll and begin passing her hand over it. The candles start to flicker. And again, the room starts to fill with the scent of, this time it's a scent of cinnamon mixed in with a little bit of, I'll say cinnamon and allspice. Cinnamon and allspice. So it's fall. I think we can go with that theme. We're making pumpkin pie.
Finally.
It's all Cedric wanted, just some pumpkin pie.
Yep.
You guys thought he was broody. He was actually just waiting for pumpkins.
Just really hungry.
All year. He's hangry.
There you go.
I'm grabbing Andrea's hand. I'm nervous.
Aww. Cedric's pulling out his weapon.
Violetta.
This just came out of nowhere, I'm sorry.
Halicer also is going to very carefully leave all of her weapons behind, just in case!
Yes.
And maybe remove the armor.
That's a good idea. Violetta will place the Eye of Andraste onto her face. You can put it onto her face. And she begins casting some sort of ritual with it. Eye of Andraste, allow us to see, show us the properties of this object so that we may learn how to rid our friend of this curse. As she says, then she starts giving some sort of incantation, and the eye of Andraste starts to glow. And she is aiming the eye towards Halaser's necklace. And while this is happening, Violetta says, "My, we have a resistant one here." She says, "It's no use, my dear. Tell us who you are. Eye of Andraste, show us. Show us who this creature, this vile creature is." And she's saying it in a very authoritative voice in order to help, as if helping the device pierce through whatever defenses this being within the necklace is. And then after a few moments, she says, yes, it's working. It's working. Tell me who you are, she says. And then finally, this very odd expression goes over her and she gasps. That was unexpected. Halaser, the being inside of your necklace is not a demon. It's a soul. The soul of Mafaroth, the betrayer.
What?
The husband of Andraste himself. How he ended up in that necklace, though. What exactly do you want, Mafaroth? Why are you not in the Fade with the rest of the souls? She again starts to cast another spell. I see. After a moment, something washes over Violetta and she goes into this trance. And she says the following words. Almost, her voice sounds a little, again, altered. Almost like somebody took her voice and changed it using Audacity or something. And she says these words. Mafaroth was born as an Avar when the Avars were still part of the Alamari tribes. His parents, Hagar II and Thelois, were both powerful Alamari. Through marriage, they established a powerful tribe controlling majority of today's Eastern Ferelden. Before they died of a common sickness, they managed to train their son as a skilled tactician and general. When Mafaroth was of age, he married Andraste, the daughter of Eldorath, the chieftain of an Alamari Chrysirian tribe, whose lands spread across modern Free Marches and Navarra and northern modern Ferelden. When Eldorath died, Mafaroth inherited his lands, and through marriage with Andraste, they established the biggest Alamari tribe the world has seen, covering most of modern Ferelden, Navarra, and the Free Marches. Though he was her husband, Mafaroth was the one who in the end betrayed Andraste and sold her to the Magisters in exchange for keeping the lands that Andraste had conquered from the weakened Tevinter Imperium. According to the Chantry, Mafaroth betrayed his wife because he grew tired of being second to the Maker in Andraste's eyes. However, the general consensus among historians is that he betrayed Andraste in order to rule the lands she had conquered. After his betrayal, Mafaroth attempted to rule, but when Archon Hesarion converted to the Chant of Light and publicly revealed Mafaroth's betrayal, the barbarians that had followed Andraste quickly abandoned him and his tribe eventually crumbled. In the end, Mafaroth was killed by his own sons. However, before his final breath, Mafaroth was seen by his loyal friend who happened to be an augur. Mafaroth had spoken to this augur prior, knowing that his life could be in danger. The augur cast a powerful spell that transferred Mafaroth's soul into a necklace. Mafaroth was going to give to his wife as a gift before his jealousy.
The necklace possessed a curse
that transformed the wearer into Mafarat's body, allowing him to take over, genesing the soul out of the body, effectively killing the host. The augur flees and hides in the cave where the present-day mines are. He ends up being discovered by those loyal to Andraste, and they kill him. The necklace falls to the ground during the scuffle and becomes lost in the mine for centuries, until now. And then after Violetta says those words, she like breaks out of the trance again, and then the candles stop flickering, and the smell of the cinnamon and allspice starts to dissipate. Violetta looks very exhausted, and she walks quickly over to her chair, and she collapses into it, catching her breath. Oh my.
Oh my. Are you alright, my lady?
Yes, I just need to gather my bearings. That was intense, to say the least. Oh my.
It looks intense.
However angry she is, I'm sure Violetta keeps some sort of drink or something in her wagon, so she will silently just pour a drink for Violetta.
Halicere, you realize that those visions that you were seeing of somebody being burned was a third person view, because mm-hmm. it was the view of Mafarath himself watching
right.
his wife die before yeah. his eyes at the stake.
Mm-hmm.
For those of you who play Dragon Age Origins, there is a ghost of Mafarath that appears mm-hmm. during the trial
yep.
of the Sacred Ashes. And if you see, his skin is slightly darker, a darker shade, which makes him almost the spitting image of a male Halicere. Almost.
Sure. Oh my God.
Thank you for choosing that photo, by the way.
Oh, Rachel. Always a pleasure.
I am super uncomfortable that all of this is real. I don't. It's just Andrea's like.
So is the curse? What happened? I don't understand. Is he gone?
No, but we learned where the curse came from. We learned who it is. It was put into this necklace by an augur, which means the best way of getting it out is with an augur. We need to find an augur. Normal mage, very powerful mage, could also do it without being an augur. But it is going to be risky. It can put that mage's life in danger as well. I don't believe that I am powerful enough of a mage to do it myself. And I hate to say this, but you are looking for someone who is about as powerful as the Archon himself, unless we can find an augur.
Right.
Kenna, my dear, you absolutely do not know any survivors, any Avarian tribes that may have an augur amongst them that we can ask for help.
I've looked. There was something that I found back in my hold that is, I was going to bring it up later when things were a little less dire. I found this, and she's going to hold up the burgundy piece of robe. This did not belong in my hold. And there's only so many people who would know where to go, let alone why it would be in my home. Not just my hold, but where I lived and slept. I'm afraid to say who it could be, but there was a hair inside of it, Violetta. if it was somebody from my home, maybe they would know where the others would be. I don't want to hope that somebody's alive, because I've hoped for so long, and if it's not, it's just another disappointment. But
Violetta's eyebrows furrow and she sees the cloth and she says, "Burgundy again."
Burgundy. Yes. I was going to bring it to you and Cedric, because you guys are involved with the Burgundy, these people. But it would seem that we need to address this now.
Those are the people that work for Trallif, yes?
Yes.
So,
if it was one of... I can't believe I'm saying this, but if it was one of my brothers, one of them, Eric was... He was an ogre.
You think that your brother is the one who owns this burgundy cloth?
It can't be. I just...
I squeeze her hand.
I need to know. I don't know. If somebody was there, I need to know that. But if it was my brother, then he could help. But it can't be. They were lost in the blight.
I don't have the ability to fully identify someone based on their hair, but what I can do is determine if two people are related to each other through their hair. That I can do.
And do what you need to do. And she'll hold out her hair.
Violetta will take out a pair of tweezers and just pull out.
Ouch.
Sorry, ouch. Dear.
That's okay. That's all right. Been through worse.
All right. Let's hope that this doesn't send us into another dead end. She takes out her voodoo doll again, and she pins Kenna's hair carefully onto the doll, and then she takes the other piece of hair carefully with a pair of tweezers from the cloth, and she also pins it to the doll. Again, the candles start to flicker as she passes her hand over the doll, and a violet mist appears around the doll. Her eyes become pupilless. They become purple pupilless eyes. And then after a few moments, she breaks out of the trance again, and she looks towards Kenna and she says, "It's a match. Whoever this is, you are related to the person who wore this cloak, or at least whose hair is on this burgundy cloak, this burgundy cloth."
He's alive.
Someone you're related to is.
Okay. I walk away.
When Kenna leaves, I think Violetta is going to say, "I didn't want to say this in Kenna's presence, but I'm glad that we might have found a relative of hers is still alive, but I can't help but be uneased by the fact that the hair was on a burgundy piece of cloth."
No, me neither. Out of character, don't we know that Trelev's bodyguard's name is Eric? Like, weren't we?
You do.
Didn't we find that out already?
Yes, you do.
Yeah, so like...
Was it Eric or Ari?
Ari is there too, but Eric I thought was the bodyguard.
Ari is the bodyguard. Eric is the auger.
Okay.
Eric is the auger.
Oh, so we haven't heard the name Eric in regards to.
You haven't heard the name Eric. You have not heard the name Eric.
Well, okay. No. Sevion, when we were in Orsimar,
yes, Sevion.
Do you know Eric?
Do you know Eric?
I mean, I don't think
that's
I don't
right.
Think I would make that Sevion connection.
Did. Okay, so. Cedric and I heard that.
Yes,
okay.
You
so, that name sounds a bit familiar, doesn't it, Cedric?
Cedric will like try to think back, and it's like, kinda. Not really. Okay. I don't really remember it, but sounds familiar.
Okay. It sounds familiar. Right. Okay, I'm gonna go check on Kenna. Be right back.
How is it familiar?
Mr. Hannock.
Yeah, I feel like Sevion said something to Cedric, but I'm not 100%. Like, it was a while ago. I heard the name once, but it was connected to the burgundy stuff.
It was connected to that armor. Was... when you saw the armor.
Yes.
It was connected to the burgundy things. It was connected to the armor, and it is connected to Sevian.
Yes.
Some way.
I know. This day just keeps getting better.
May I make a suggestion, Violetta says? Mm.
Go ahead.
There is another option. Again, we don't know if this lead is necessarily going to take us to Kenna's Augur brother. It's a long right. shot, but in case it doesn't, the other option is for us to go back to where this necklace was found. If we can find the remains of this Augur, I may be able to channel the ability to remove this curse from you, possibly. Which means that my caravan would have to make their way back to the mines. In the meantime.
Is there no way that...
It's a good second step, but...
It is a good second step, but, like my sister says...
I'm just saying, if you want to go...
You don't...
Doing something else in the meantime, you may.
That's a good idea. Understood, but do you need to have all of your people in that area? I just worry for their safety.
That is true. We could just send my wagon alone there. Whatever has the mirror. Or just the mirror in general.
Perhaps a mirror in general would be a better idea. I don't know. Have you any idea how to neutralize this thing? I was not particularly in an emotional, heightened... I was on watch when this happened. I would understand more if I was in a blaze of anger. But this happened unexpectedly. Is there any way to neutralize this?
At least slow it temporarily? Till we can...
Yes.
I have done what I could during the ritual to slow it down, but at the end of the day, Halaser, it is your will and your will alone that determines how much time you have left. Saying that, Halaser, roll me a willpower save, please. And you will have to make a willpower save every single day.
Yay!
Every single day. 19, you're
well,
fine.
First one's really nice. It's 19.
You're fine for today.
Excellent.
That's terrifying.
Mm-hmm. I know, right?
As each day passes, the check gets more and more difficult.
Of course it does.
No.
So
oh, God.
Time is of the essence.
So time suddenly becomes of the essence.
Time becomes the essence.
Nice.
Decide what you're going to do.
Yeah, we gotta pick quick. And, you know, I like to say how powerful I am, but I'm not Archon powerful, so.
Anybody want to talk to the Archon?
Yes.
I'll do it.
Yeah, but we do, but, you know, not in a nice way.
Oh, we have to be nice? Never mind. I should
Yeah, boo, whatever. Okay.
I'm going to grab Kenna. And then we can figure out where we're going.
Yes.
Go team.
Take it. Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Go to her, Violetta.
Yes.
First of all, we should use the eye on you as well.
Yes, that would be wonderful.
Is it safe for me to do that, or should somebody else?
It is best used. It is best used by a mage.
Then perhaps when Andrea returns. Also, is there... If something like this happens again, if Mephareth comes through, do you have anything to take me out of commission as quickly as possible? Understanding that I won't be able to do it myself. So maybe an item or even a poison or something. I don't need to, I don't mean to kill me. I just mean to knock me out.
Yes, Hali dear. Yes, I do have... We do have in this camp our fair share of Antivan poisons. Yes. She says that as if, yeah, I guess I can...
Like I didn't already know.
Like you didn't already know. Because like having her say it out loud is different from, you know, mm-hmm. having it just be understood.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah.
Cedric raises an eyebrow.
Yeah, she probably should have asked everyone else to step out first, but not quite thinking straight.
So first of all, when Andrea looks for Kenna, what is she doing? What does she look like at the moment?
Kenna is sort of behind a tree, just sitting down, bawling. Just got like her head in her lap.
Go ahead, Andrea.
Oh no! Oh no! I'm gonna go over, trying to be respectful, but I'm going to sit down on the ground beside her and put my hand up over her head and my other hand on her hand. It's been a big day for you, hasn't it? I know. I've been through this same thing pretty recently. It kind of knocks your socks off.
Okay. I've been looking for so long.
Yeah.
And then. Back at the mountain, I said goodbye to everything, and now he's back, and
I mean,
I don't know which one, if it was Ari or Eric, or maybe they're both alive, maybe, what are they doing with the Burgundy people?
Well, I mean, we still don't know anything about the Burgundy people, except that they're probably not
assholes.
Good people.
Huh? No.
They're probably not good people, but I mean, your brothers are young, right?
They're 18 now.
Yeah, they're young, you know. When I was younger than them, I wasn't really the best judge of character. So, you know, I can assume that they're in the same boat. Sometimes you think you're doing the right thing and you're not. And sometimes you're just trying to survive.
They've been alone for so long. I wish I'd have looked harder. I wish I never thought to look in the cities.
This is not your fault, Kenna. This is good news. And it sounds like they've been together.
If they're both alive, it was just one.
Well, it's funny you should say that. You said Ari is the second brother, right?
Yeah.
Okay. When we were in Orzammar, the name Eric came up in regards to the Burgundy armor. And when we were in Tevinter,
I remember about the winter, they said Ari, but I didn't.
I know, but, I mean, it could be both of them. together. I mean, and if that's the case, they've at least had each other, like you've had Esbjorn, and it's going to be okay.
I have to find them, Andrea.
I know.
I need to see them.
We will. If what we know about Adi is true, then he is in Navarra right now. We know at least that much. He's with Trowliff in Navarra.
That's great. Okay.
It's going to be really scary. And you're going to cry more than you are right now.
I don't know if I have anything left.
You do, trust me. It just keeps coming and coming. But it is going to be all right. And if your brothers are alive, and it sounds like they are, then they're going to have their big sister back. That's good.
I have a family again.
Yes, you're going to have your family again.
I'm going to kick their asses.
You probably should. that's probably what you should do. Yeah.
All right. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Okay.
No, sorry. Okay, so we're on a bit of a time crunch.
Yes.
So we need to find your brothers, and then you'll have your family, and we can save Halisair. We have two ways to do it. One is with an augur, and one is to find the bones of the old augur.
Okay.
I'd prefer to find your brother.
I'll find him anyway. Whichever one will help Hali out the most. We'll do that.
Very good.
All right. Okay.
Are you all right?
I'm okay.
Okay. All right. I'm going to help you up. I'm really weak, right, though, so don't pull me over.
All right.
I will go back and we'll do this. Okay?
Find my family.
Find your family.
Okay. Let's go. Let's go.
Okay. And I'll just help her up and walk her back.
Okay.
Ooh, kiddo.
You bring her back into the wagon with everyone gathered, plus cardboard Theobin. And what do you guys do?
She will look at Kenna just to see how she's doing.
Okay, Hali. We need to focus on you right now. Losing you is not an option. So, Andrea says we can either find my brother or we could go back to the caves.
Yes.
Which one helps you the most? Which one is certainly going to help you?
I can't speak with any authority as to certainty. It sounds like both are going to be a risk. Either we go and we find the remains of the first augur and thus Violetta risks herself, or we go find our Burgundy friends and find your brother. It's a risk either way. And I don't know the right answer. I don't know what's going to be fastest.
That is my biggest concern. We know where to look, but Navarre is a very big city, and the whole Burgundy thing, it could bring up a whole bunch of problems that we just don't have time
to have to face anyway.
Well, yeah. Violetta says, wasn't there that one mirror that you guys haven't gone through yet that supposedly is in possession of the Burgundy mages, whoever these people are?
Isn't that yours, Cedric?
Yes, it is.
Oh. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
So, maybe we go through it. This could be very dangerous.
going into the viper's nest, if you will.
Yeah. I'm in.
We don't know what we're going to find.
It's been a few days since I've had a good fight. Just...
Well, Violetta, is there any preparation you need to do for our failsafe?
She says, that depends on whether or not I am going to continue accompanying you. If so, then no preparation needed. Otherwise, I don't mind passing on a pin dipped into the poison to whoever it is does come with you.
Sure.
Poison?
In case I lose control, something to just knock me out.
Doesn't Theo have one?
I'm sure he does. I think Theo has many poisons. And I think sometimes he mixes them up with his drinks.
I'm sure either will do.
All right. So the caravans are going to the caves in case?
Just in case we end up with a dead end.
That's good.
Sure. Just please be careful.
It's good. It's good.
Is Violetta going with the caravans? Is she not coming with us?
We have not decided that yet. Who would be the best to come with us?
Do we know how many people can go through that mirror with you?
No.
No.
Maybe we should figure that out.
All right.
Unless it's going to drop us right into the middle of things, in which case...
Why don't we go look through it? From this side, so we can like peek in.
I thought it looked like out of character. I thought it was just like I thought you couldn't.
Oh, you can't see.
Like, yeah, I thought it was like.
You have to go through it to see what's in it.
Okay,
sure.
Just poke our heads in real quick.
Yeah. Hey guys, we're all sunken underwater. Let's go through. Before we leave, Andrea. Would you mind assisting with the eye? Would the rest of you mind stepping out a moment?
All right.
This is a very powerful magical artifact, yes?
Oh, yes. Yes, it is, indeed.
Yeah, I can use it.
You don't feel comfortable doing so.
I'm pretty comfortable with my ability to stave off demons, but what did it feel like when you used it, Violetta?
It's a little disorienting if you're not used to it. It basically, think of it almost like it's giving you a sixth sense, if that makes any sense.
Is it similar to walking in the Fade?
I would say that there's some similarities to it, yes.
Okay. I can do that. Okay.
All right, dear. You just place it over your face. You focus your magic through the eye and then focus on the cursed person or object that you're trying to get information on. What you are trying to find is the counterpart to this, she says. And she goes over to a safe over to her wall, and she turns the combination, and she unlocks it and comes out with this really... it looks like an ordinary arrow made of steel. It doesn't look magical. It doesn't look like it's anything special. But... She holds it up and says, this is what you should focus on to find its partner.
I'm going to take it, I guess, and just hold it.
Just be careful that thing. It doesn't pierce anyone's skin, dear.
Okay.
Whoops.
Oh, no.
Hold on a second, Cedric.
I was just about to have Hali ask, yeah.
Okay. Just out of curiosity, what's it do?
Nothing good.
Okay.
You'll learn it when you focus the eye on it.
Okay.
Better
okay.
than I could explain.
Did you still want us out of the room?
That is up to Violetta. It's just that it was not her. It was not.
I understand.
My secret.
I understand.
I don't mind at all, dears.
Then if you're fine, I'm fine.
I suppose if you are willing to help me with this, you probably should know what it involves and what it entails.
Right.
Very well.
Like, I guess I'll see you guys on the other side. And I put the eye up against my eye.
You put the eye against your eye, and I would like for you to make a magic roll.
Okay. 18?
18. The eye begins to glow, Andrea, and again, it's almost like you gain a new sense that, almost like if you were a blind person suddenly becoming, suddenly seeing, or a deaf person suddenly hearing, like this dormant extra sense that you didn't know existed opens up, and it starts feeding you with knowledge of the object that you're focusing on. And with this particular arrow, you basically gain the knowledge that I gave to Kenna several sessions ago about,
okay.
you know, the arrow of love and the arrow of hatred and all that good stuff, and how it is...
And this one's hatred, right?
Yes. And yep. it only uses its full ability if it's used by the people. It has to be wielded by an elf. Otherwise, it has a muted effect, which is what happened to Violetta, in which case she cannot love. She does not have the ability to okay. love anymore. It will show you the current person in possession, that the last current possession, known possessor of the arrow, which is Violetta. She currently possesses it. And then it starts talking about the other arrow, and you see an elf girl. The image of an elf girl who you've never met before, and a name is branded into your head, the name Lithia Ashala.
Yep.
Lithia Ashala.
Uh-huh.
And then the image disappears, and then the Eye of Andraste completes.
Are you okay?
You're still disoriented. Yeah. It's a little dizzying, like, again.
I'll probably need to sit.
About as disorienting as a colorblind person who only saw the world in black and white, all of a sudden, colors! Oh, the colors! It's beautiful, but it's overwhelming at the same time. That kind of thing.
That was... an experience, guys.
And you can see how powerful and useful of an item that is, dear.
Mm-hmm. I can. It's unlike anything I've ever experienced. I know who has the arrow of love.
Okay.
And it's funny because we were already looking for her. It's an elven girl named Lithia Ashala.
That's not Tangerine.
Tangerine's granddaughter. Yeah.
Yes.
And we were already supposed to be looking for her, so.
Funny.
Another reason to find her.
Funny how you guardians are always being tugged in the right directions, even without knowing it.
It is funny. Interesting. Okay. Well, we're still not 100% as to where to find her. We have some clues.
Yes.
That's fine. But... we have more pressing matters to deal with. Lydia can wait.
The eye didn't tell you where she was? Or anything?
It did not tell her where she was. Who possessed it last, the known possessor of it. It could, hopefully, Mrs. Shal is still alive. That would be very helpful. If not, that would make our search a lot more difficult.
Yes.
Well,
it's a little worrying anyway that it's in the hands of an elf, right? Because they have a bit more control over it than...
It was made by the elven gods, so that would make sense.
Yes. The reason in this one affected you the way it did, and I'm going to, like, hand it back to her carefully, is because it wasn't used by an elf.
Huh.
It would have been a lot... It would have been really different, I guess. It would have killed her, right?
No, it would have given her... It would have imbued her with utter hatred.
Oh, it could have been a lot worse, actually, Violetta.
Versus the arrow of love, which would have put them into smitten with utter love, which can also be dangerous. Also be very dangerous.
Yeah. So that was... I mean, I don't want to... It could have been a lot worse. You could be obsessed with hatred, so...
That's fine.
I'm not saying that you're in a good position now. I'm just saying it could get worse, but now we can make it better, so...
It's a start.
But when we use the arrow, I don't think it can be an elf that touches the arrow. Unless you just want to fall in love with the closest person. Completely.
I would prefer my love to be non-artificial. Yes, thank you.
Indeed.
Yes. Okay.
So, do you give the eye back to Violetta when you're done?
I haven't yet, no.
Okay.
I gave her back the arrow.
You give her back the arrow. She will probably be waiting for the eye back as well.
Cedric's gonna ask for the eye.
Okay.
I am not a mage, so I will look after it until we can return it.
Why? What is there a reason you would not leave it with Violetta thus far?
It was, to my understanding, it was given to us on loan.
Yes.
Yeah, it sounded like Leildon wanted us to give it back.
It's best we return it to not sully the trust of the left hand.
I am not disagreeing with you.
Violetta is a mage.
Yes.
I am.
I just feel like it would be best if a non-mage would handle the eye.
Are you?
If a non-mage handles the eye, its abilities are muted. They don't reach its full potential, which means that the eye cannot help as many people with a non-mage.
I don't intend to use it. I tend to keep it safe until the time to return it.
And I intend to use it to help other people. Instead of just merely keeping it safe, not being used, and not letting it keep its full potential, and do what it was created to do, to help people.
It is not ours to judge what to do with it.
Yeah, I'm gonna lean toward Kevin. Like, I'm super uncomfortable right now. Like, I'm just holding the eye, like.
You're like the dog in the middle, and the two parents are like, "Come here, boy, come here."
What are Ken and Halasir doing?
I mean,
actually, here's a question. I know that Kenna had gone off to be by herself on the land of her people. So was Andrea the only one witnessing that ritual and its effects?
I would probably say so, especially since you guys are too busy meditating. If you're meditating, then I don't think you're paying attention to anything.
That is fantastic. Okay, good.
Why? That makes me worried.
It would have been a point of contention.
Okay.
But, no, it's not there now, so this is good.
Go ahead.
Go ahead, yeah.
Go ahead, Kenna.
Oh, okay. I mean, was the Chantry just holding on to it? They're not using it. It kind of seems a little selfish. I don't know. I'm kind of with Violetta on this.
Thank you, Kenna. Someone with reason.
It just seems like if you have the ability to help, why wouldn't you use it?
It's almost like your bracers. If you decided to just not use them, and that's, I'm assuming they were given to you to help people, not allowed, and sort of like giving your bracers to somebody else to not be used.
Moreover, we agreed that the item would be on loan. We did not say how long it would be loaned for. And while I fully intend to honor that agreement, if we are still potentially in need of it, why should it not go to the person who had it before?
I would also agree with that. We do need it
still. And I might point out that each of us, having, well, obvious exception being my sister, each of us who has spent their lives not having any sort of magical connection, we are now as magical as the person who has been attuned to this artifact for that long. So, I think Violetta should hold it.
Is it a question, Cedric, that you do not believe that I would use such a thing responsibly? Because I think that I have worked very hard to earn the group's trust up to this point.
I don't think that was... I thought, okay, you wanted us to get this back to help Hali and yourself.
Yes.
And others, possibly, which I completely respect.
Yes.
But we had to ask permission to take it, and we took it, and we're borrowing it, and I don't, you know, but we are borrowing it on terms that we are going to return it,
and I don't... we are.
Are we? Is that your, is that the intent, Violetta? Because, or would you rather keep it for yourself?
What were the actual terms?
To continue helping.
What were the actual terms of returning it?
I said I would give it back to him.
When?
That sounds pretty... that sounds pretty underhanded.
Point is... at least the point I'm taking. We did not give a time frame, nor had Leildon asked for a time frame. It's not my intent to keep this thing on the long term. I believe it should be returned, but since we may still need it for now, if we need to ask for longer, that's fine.
I don't feel comfortable making this decision. I just put the eye on the table and I walk out of the room.
When we return to the White Spire, we can send another message to the Hand and see how long he is willing to keep it apart.
Either way, we still need it now. So yes, it doesn't matter if whatever we decide to do with it. We have things we need to do.
Yes,
we can't sit here and argue. So
I
don't care who has the eye. We need it now. So let's go.
Agreed.
Violetta has proven herself over and over again. Mm-hmm. I say let her hold on to it. She's the only one who can use it properly. Besides Andrea, but I mean...
Hmm.
You did marvelous, though. You did great.
I was outside.
I know.
Is Cedric going to do anything? Because right now the eye is on the table.
If that is the group's decision, so be it. But know that I'm against it. And Cedric will get up and walk out of the room.
I give the eye and I hand it to Violetta.
Pissy Templars.
Thank you.
You've earned my trust, my lady.
Thank you. I apologize if I caused any grief contentions. That was not my intent.
No, you've done nothing wrong.
At any rate, the important thing right now is that we help cure Halicer as quickly as possible. That is the important thing. So, are you all deciding to go through that mirror that Cedric went through originally?
Sounds like we are doing both. We just have to decide who to take with us on this potentially. We don't know where the mirror is going to be at this point, so we need to figure out who we're taking.
Well, either way, we need to go through it.
Yes.
The one here.
All right. If you want to stay with your people for now, that's fine. We will return to let you know what decisions have been made.
I think since I've been away from them for so long, that might be the best thing.
Very well.
Well, you're leaving us for now.
How convenient.
It's up to you. Halicer offered, but if you believe that my services would be better spent at the White Spire, fair enough.
I think your services would be better wherever we decide to, like, if we go through Cedric's mirror, your skills would be greatly appreciated.
I think so too.
I know you want to be with your people, and I hate to ask, but we still need your help.
I told you at the beginning that I would see this through to the end, and I intend to keep my promise.
Thank
you. I was merely responding to the offer that Halicer made. It wasn't something that I brought up, it was something that she brought up.
I understand. All right. Well, I'll give you a privacy to say goodbye to your people. And I'll give her a hug, and then I'll
hug you back.
Yeah.
All right. Well.
All right.
I suppose just let me know if you would like me to come with into Navarra.
I will let you know. You are, of course, welcome to rejoin us at the Spire, but being a leader to your people, I assumed you might like a moment with them while we are making up our minds.
Of course. All right.
Thank you for your help.
You are most welcome, Hali. I'm glad that we have finally made some progress on both of our problems.
Yeah. Me too.
Okay.
Yep.
What happens next?
I'm assuming we all go through the caravan's mirror. Are we going straight to Cedric?
No, we need to bring people.
Yeah.
Is there that's what I was worried. I was like, we're not just jumping in this, right, guys?
No.
Yeah. Is there a way to look at the mirror and see how many people can come through it with us?
Yes.
Okay, so why don't we go check that before we go pick our party?
I agree.
You guys will go over to that mirror. The number of people that you can bring with you is 3.
Oh. Mm.
Nice.
Cedric, do you have any idea where that mirror is going to go? I mean, I know you want a boat.
The last I saw of that mirror, it was being fished out of the sea.
Oh.
Therefore, it might be on a boat. It might be locked away. It might be in somebody's boudoir.
Do we want to just peek our heads through real quick?
I don't know.
Just to make sure we're not, like, underwater.
For that exact reason, I don't think that would be a great idea.
All right. It's just throwing it out there. All right.
We have this choice of 3 people to bring.
Yes.
Yeah. Let's look at our NPCs real quick. Kimberly, what
out of character, I vote Hugh.
Oh, too close! Oh,
It makes me so sad that the picture's not there anymore.
I know. But...
yeah.
Okay. Right. I'd like Connor to come with.
Yes.
Yeah. I feel like it's been a while since we've had Connor. Plus, yeah, he might be helpful. I think we should bring Violetta too.
Yes. We're definitely bringing Violetta.
Pigeon crap.
Are we doing this in character?
I'm not letting
the
eye out of my damn sight.
Really? Really?
Is this in character?
Yes.
Oh, good.
Sorry. Yes, it is in character.
Okay.